We're not interested in status being the outcome of our institution. We're not interested in exclusion being the means by which we drive forward our reputation. What we're interested in is human success across the broadest spectrum of people possible.
Everything we do at ASU is focused in on impact. If you want to focus in on impact, the impact of the technology, start by actually asking the community what they want to solve for. Having access to AI tools from OpenAI, we went out with an internal grant proposal opportunity. And what came back was more than 400 proposals from our faculty, and we're working on 200 of them as we speak.
We see a future at ASU in which AI changes our relationship with knowledge, in a sense, democratizing access so that students begin to be better at problem solving and working more like researchers.
One of the barriers when you are collaborating, especially on research, a lot of times it's interdisciplinary. You're working with people who have varying expertise. ChatGPT helps you establish shared language, shared processes, and that's been a real game changer.
People are excited because they now have concrete examples to point to for use cases in which AI is improving their outcomes in the classroom. A project came out of our School of International Letters and Cultures to create a language buddy based on ChatGPT. It's a patient and always available tutor who speaks in a personalized way that's accessible. The second project we're really excited about is using AI in our composition classes. A lot of the rhetoric around AI is that it's going to end writing. But we're really interested in working and showing how AI can actually be used to support better writing.
We measure our success by the success of our students. The introduction of ChatGPT Edu is enormously important. It helps us protect our student privacy, that we protect the research output, our intellectual property, and also supports our security requirements, whether that's on the research or on the teaching and learning environment. And that is something that every CIO, in fact, every university president needs to be mindful of.
We have long dreamt about individualized, personalized learning without constraints. No more preconceived notion of who's smart and who's not smart. AI systems allow that individual to pursue learning in a way in which they can have the learning outcomes that they desire. We're going to see tremendous enhancement in these individuals. And who knows what happens at that point? We think it's all likely to be very, very positive.